Hey, Randy, here's a puzzler for you. Name an award-winning actor, writer, director, musician, and songwriter who also happens to be British royalty.
Do I look like Ken Jennings? Seriously, how about an audio daily double?
Sure thing.
Hi, we're going to talk about some nice things today. Did you know that? Sure, some special things for you, some special things for me too.
I'm Steve McClellan.
And I'm Randy Hodgins, and Steve's audio clue was none other than Christopher Guest, true comedy royalty whose career now spans six decades. Born in 1948 to British-American parents, Guest holds a hereditary peerage as the fifth Baron Hayden Guest. It's mostly honorary, but likely a lot of fun to trot out at New York University, where he attended theater school.
Guest found his first career break with the National Lampoon Radio Hour, from which we took his great Mr. Rogers impression. He also had a gift for deflating bloated music industry egos.
That's what they do. They sing wailing songs. No instruments. No guitar. No bass. No drums. No Moog. Nothing. Dumper. In the dumper, those instruments. Flush them down the toilet.
Well, what they just sing? They're a cappella, then?
A cappella. A cappella.
Guest's career exploded in the mid-80s when he signed on for a one-year stint on Saturday Night Live with Billy Crystal, Martin Short, Harry Shearer, and others that many credit with saving the show. More importantly, in 1984, he starred in Rob Reiner's This is Spinal Tap, a movie that skewered fading metal bands and launched the mockumentary genre. Spinal Tap is one of those movies that is eminently quotable. Never more so than when Guest's character, guitarist Nigel Tufnell, explains why his amps are just a bit louder than everyone else's.
If you can see,
yeah,
the numbers all go to 11. Look, right across the board, 11, oh, 11,
and most of
11,
these
and then
amps go up to 10.
Exactly.
Does that mean it's louder? Is it any louder?
Well, it's one louder, isn't it?
Much of Spinal Tap was improvised, and Guest would adopt that style for his own films, beginning in 1996 with Waiting for Guffman, a mockumentary on bad community theater. Using a repertory cast that included Eugene Levy, Fred Willard, Michael McKean, and Catherine O'Hara, he had a great run, including Best in Show and the Grammy-winning A Mighty Wind, the tale of a reunion of fake folk singing legends, the Folksmen.
Well, there's a puppy in the parlor and a skillet on the stove and a smelly old blanket and a Navajo wool. There's chicken on the table, but you gotta say grace. There's always something cooking at old Joe's place.
Guest has been married to Jamie Lee Curtis since 1984 and has two daughters. He's been less active in recent years, but resurfaced in 2016 with, you guessed it, a mockumentary made for Netflix about sports team mascots.
You can find out more about Christopher Guest and all our comedy legends, including video clips and extended audio cuts at LaughTracksRadio.com. Thanks for listening, and until next time, it's goodbye from me.
And it's goodbye from him. Goodbye, everybody.